to the Mid-Atlantic Air Museum's World War II weekend gathering of warbirds. My name is Theresa Eaman. I am beginning my 17th year here. I started when I was 5. That's all I'm saying about that. And so for the next half hour, like with many of the other musical acts, I'm going to entertain you with music from the World War II era. Of course, some of the arrangements may not sound World War II-ish. Without a band, we do the best we can here. And hopefully you'll hear some songs that you like. I will be joined on stage by Joe and Heidi, who come up from New York, down from New York City. They are amazing swing dancers, and so you'll get to enjoy a little bit of the music and the dance from this time period. I'm going to start this set and this show with a song I always start with because I am a baseball fan and believe in luck and all kinds of mojo. This is my wish for the weekend. This is a song called Blue Skies. Virginia Beach. Last week I was in New York, and now I'm here. And somewhere along the line, y'all's pollen has caught up to me. So, doing the best I can. Occasionally my voice does stuff that I don't intend. I apologize ahead of time. But we're working with the drainage and everything else. I don't know. This is actually, Pennsylvania has been the worst of the three places that I've been. And somebody told me a couple of days ago it was like the highest and worst pollen and mold that you guys had had yet. So I was like, well, that's great. I think that's the day I got here. So this next song, in light of all that, is probably the most difficult song that I sing vocally. It is a beautiful song from a movie of the same name. It's a ballad called Laura.
Thank you.
Dances from this time period. This is a song called Sentimental Journey.
Gonna take a sentimental journey. Gonna set my heart at ease. Gonna take a sentimental journey to renew. Never thought my heart could be so yearning. Why did I
next song started out being, it was recorded for a movie called Orchestra Wives by the Glenn Miller Orchestra. And this was a movie that came out shortly before Glenn Miller went overseas and unfortunately never returned. It was recorded as an instrumental and then later recorded again as a as a quad vocal song. And then it really became iconic in the 50s when Etta James recorded it. And this is the arrangement that you're familiar with, even though it is a 50s arrangement of a song from the 1940s. This is a song called At Last. Several reasons. The first is, it was the first song that my favorite singer ever got famous, got national notoriety with when she was singing with the Chick Wack Orchestra, and that of course is Ella Fitzgerald. It's also special to me because I never sung it better than I sung it here, especially when the Abbott and Costello show was here. Of course, those of you that have been here before know that show passed about a year and a half ago, and it's never ever been the same without them, but it's still pretty good because I have Joe and Heidi to dance to it, and they do a wonderful job. This is a children's nursery rhyme turned into a jazz tune. It's called A Tisket A Tasket. Thank you. have not been here before. Wow, that's not many. Welcome, 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 welcome. This is the spot where everything's happening all day long. There's great music here all day. We have our good friends over here for you to belly up to the bar and grab a nice soda or water. They take very good care of us. And so we're so happy for you to be here. For those of you that have been here before, thank you so much for returning, because it's with not without you that we get to come back. So thank you so much. Right? Thank you. This next song is a Duke Ellington tune. I quite enjoy this one. It is a silly little thing called Satin Doll, and it features Joe and Heidi again. History as they are. And I was singing and I noticed this great couple kind of dancing off to the side, sometimes only one day out of the weekend, and I was riveted by their dancing, because we always want the talent that we don't have. So I would love to be able to dance. It's not in the stars for me. I'm not a very good dancer, not gonna lie. And so we got to know each other through Facebook, and I invited them to come and dance with me. And they've been coming now for 10 years, maybe like a total of seven, actually, as part of my act. And I wanna make sure that if you fill out a survey on your way out, or the one that's inside of the program, make sure you mention Joe and Heidi, because I always wanna make sure they get to come back as part of the entertainment package, because I think they're really entertaining, right? Okay, so I'm gonna sing one more for you, because I'm gonna try and get us back on schedule, right? Because are we running late again? 11:15. So I'm going to sing one more for you, and then we'll bring the Martin sisters back up, try and get us a little bit closer to schedule. This is actually a... I'm going to sing something upbeat. I'll do some of the ballads that everybody likes at my 2 o'clock show. So this is a song called Nice Work, If You Can Get It. And we'll feature Joe and Heidi one last time. Here at the Officers Club is the Martin Sisters Band, and they are amazing and fun to watch. I'll be back later this afternoon, as will Frank Cabello, Frank Sings Frank, and America's Sweethearts, so the entertainment is not over. And when we're done over here, we'll actually move over to the bigger stage, or the outside stage outside of the hangar. So if you just can't get enough, make sure you follow us, grab a program, and it'll tell you where we'll all be throughout the day.